Welcome to this deep dive. We're diving into the excerpt you all chose, Mary Poser. And wow.
Oh, yeah.
It's already got us hooked.
I know, right? Young woman in Nashville, some kind of life-changing event. And then there's Bollywood. Color me intrigued.
Right. It's a lot of threads to untangle. So we start with Mary. And at first glance, you might think, okay, this girl's got it made. Degrees in what? Sociology and theology. Valedictorian on top of that.
Yeah, like the classic overachiever, right?
Exactly. But the excerpt, it's like it's hinting that something else is going on, like under the surface.
Oh, totally. It's all these little clues, you know, like that line she says she feels born in a cake tin and was pushed into this perfect mold.
Like she's wearing this mask, you know, putting on a good show, but inside it's different. Even that whole fear of public speaking thing.
Right. And she was valedictorian.
Exactly. It doesn't really add up, does it? Makes you wonder what's really going on in her head.
And then there's the whole theology thing, right?
Yeah.
Like, was that really her choice? Or was it more about, you know, making her mom happy?
Ooh, good point. It's like that pressure to follow the path that's laid out for you, even if it means your own dreams, like her interest in sociology, end up on the back burner.
It's that classic struggle, isn't it? Between who you are and who you think you should be. And Mary, she's stuck right in the middle of it.
Then boom, just when you think you have her all figured out, this car accident happens.
Yeah, and it's not just any accident, is it? It's almost like symbolic, you know, a turning point.
Totally agree. And the way the author describes it, relentless darkness, brilliant white light. I mean, come on.
It's like you're right there with her, disoriented, almost like a near-death experience.
Yeah.
And then there's that whole thing with the hand and the silver ring.
Oh, yeah. What's that about? It pops up a few times, but it's never really explained.
Right. Is it real? A hallucination, a symbol of something. It's like the author's messing with us, you know, leaving us hanging.
Like a good mystery should, I guess.
It's like those little details that really get under your skin, you know, make you want to know more.
Totally. And speaking of wanting to know more, enter Simha.
Oh, yeah. Talk about a plot twist. One minute she's dealing with this crazy accident. The next, there's this Bollywood filmmaker.
Right. Like, talk about a contrast. Nashville to Bollywood. That's quite the leap.
And their connection is instant, right? Like, he sees something in her, something no one else does.
And those compliments, I'd be blushing, too.
Totally. But it's deeper than just flirting, you know? It's like he makes her question everything.
And that line, my body molded to his, drinking him in.
Mm.
Oh, wow. That's intense.
Right. You really feel the connection there. But, of course, Mary, she's got her guard up, right? Guilt, confusion, the whole shebang.
Well, yeah. She's trying to figure things out with Jason, her ex, and then there's Simha, this whole other world.
It's like her head's telling her one thing, but her heart's saying something else entirely.
The classic dilemma, right? Safety and familiarity versus the excitement of the unknown. And you can see that playing out in the different worlds they come from too, right?
Oh, absolutely. Nashville versus this whole international Bollywood lifestyle. Talk about a clash of cultures.
And don't forget the smaller details too.
Yeah.
Like his vegetarianism. It's not just the dietary choice, it's tied to his faith, his upbringing.
Exactly. It's like Simha's presence, it just highlights all these different perspectives, makes her question everything she thought she knew. And then there's that butterfly thing, right? It's like everywhere in this excerpt.
Oh, totally. Butterflies, they always make me think of transformation, you know? Like shedding your old self and becoming something new.
Right. And Mary, she's definitely at a crossroads, trying to figure out who she wants to be.
It's like she's been living in this cocoon, this safe but kind of stifling world. And now she's starting to realize there's a whole other way to live.
Exactly. Like with the nickname, My Little Butterfly. At first it seems cute, but then you realize it's kind of loaded, you know, like a prophecy or something.
And Aunt Sarah's butterfly enclosure.
Yeah.
That whole thing about it being a place of peace and change. Come on, that's not an accident.
Totally. It's like the author's hitting us over the head with the metaphor, right?
Yeah.
But it works.
It totally does. And you can't forget about the biggest transformation of all, right? Mary walking out on her own wedding.
Seriously. That's a power move right there. She's like, nope. Oh. I'm not going to live my life for anyone else but me.
She's finally realizing she has a choice. You know, she doesn't have to follow the path that's been laid out for her.
So the big question is, what's she going to choose? Jason? The safe bet? Or Simha, the leap into the unknown.
Right. And I love how the excerpt doesn't give us a definitive answer. It's left up to us to decide, to imagine what might happen.
It's like the author saying, hey, this is just the beginning of Mary's story. What do you think happens next?
And that's the beauty of a good story, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
It stays with you long after you finish reading. Makes you think, makes you wonder.
This deep dive, it's been quite a ride. Butterflies, Bollywood, life-changing decisions, phew.
Who knew? A simple excerpt could be so packed with stuff to unpack.
That's what we're here for. And we want to hear from you. What did you think of Mary's story? What resonated with you? Hit us up on our socials and let's keep the conversation going. Until next time, happy reading.